Everybody, I wanted to show you my altered box that I made for a swap. Kelly at Blackheart's Prim and I decided to do a swap, and she wanted to do like altered paper mache boxes. And although she told me her style was like whimsy and she liked red, I wasn't quite sure what whimsy was for me. And I had this paper on hand and I absolutely love this paper. So I decided to do the Wizard of Oz, and I don't know how much detail I can go into it for you here. I just wanted to give you guys a quick look. But this bottom box here, I covered the whole box, both boxes, with the paper and layers of paper Mod Podge on top. That was the only way I really knew to adhere everything good. And just kind of going around it real quick. I did all the little cutouts and adhered those on there. So that's that. I made these little flowers since I really don't have a flower collection, so I just used the paper and cut out with my flower punches some flowers and figured out how to make some flowers to put on the front there, put a little bit of stickles on there. And then this was just a little wooden fence that I have. I cut a little section of it off, put that on there, and then I fussy cut this little piece right here out of one of like the little postcards or something. And after I fussy cut it, it, you know, obviously was sticking above the box, and I was like, wow, what am I going to do to keep it from getting, you know, bumped or every time the lid goes off and on? So after I had fussy cut it out, I came up with the idea of backing it with acetate. So that's what I did. I glued the actual cutout on some acetate and tried to trim around it. Obviously, I didn't trim as close as the paper. You could see it a little bit there. But at least it gives the paper some stability, and like when the lid goes off and on, it does slide down behind them. So that worked out pretty well. And what else can I tell you here? You know, just everything, I just backed it with the acetate, cut the little banner out there. It said Emerald City. I figured it looks like they were all on their way to Emerald City. And then on the top part here, I'm going to try to move my iPad a little bit. On the top part, same thing. I just fussy cut some different papers, you know, little pieces out of different things. I was really low on this paper pad. So, you know, the Good Witch, that was the biggest thing I had of her. I put her there, the little ghost, Dorothy's shoes, I don't know what his character actually was. And then, right here underneath this box, it's actually, glued down. I put the witch's feet, you remember, like how she was under the house after the tornado. And then I actually glued this box to this lid. It does come off, but then so does the top lid. And, everything, like I said, once again has the acetate behind it to hold it in place. And as I was trying to figure out what to do with the top of it, I had asked some other crafting friends some ideas, and someone came up with the idea for the red slippers. And I was thinking, where the heck am I going to find red slippers or little shoes? So after thinking about it for a little bit, I remember growing up, we always used to have, when you had the bridal showers and the baby showers, you could always find the little plastic things you'd put the candy in. So I headed out to Party City, and I had no luck there, but I did find these at Joann's. I had to had to buy the whole box of 24, but that's okay. I'm going to sell them all off on the scrapyard. So I used the two, and I just put Mod Podge down, and then extra fine glitter, and then another layer of Mod Podge, glitter. I can't even tell you how many layers I did. I just did a lot. And then after it was all done, I sprayed it with a matte adhesive sealer. Probably should have did glossy, but I don't have any glossy. All I had was matte, and I didn't want to go out and buy anything else, but they're still pretty sparkly. So that is the top. Let's see if I could try to lift it up a little bit here and give you a different angle. I don't want to make anybody sick. But so that's the box. Like I said, both lids do come off. I'm going to fill it with goodies and send that off to Kelly. I really hope she likes it. By the time I post this, I know that she'll have received it. So this was the best I could do, since I really wasn't quite sure of a whimsy style, but who doesn't love the Wizard of Oz? So, Kelly, I really hope you enjoy it, and if you guys have any questions or comments, please leave them below, and I thank you guys for watching. Talk to you later.